Welcome to Piping Tutorial YouTube channel. In this video, we will learn how to fabricating pipeline with pipe fitting. This video provides excellent information for pipe fitters. Please do not forget to subscribe to our channel before starting the video. Let's starting pipe tutorial video. In this video, we will use pipe fittings 3D model and will try to explain with examples how to manufacture a pipe spool using different pipe fittings. As you see, this is a fabricated pipe spool. This pipe spool consists of 3 off pipe pieces, 2 off 90 degree butt weld elbows, 1 off pipe T, and 3 of weld neck flange. Let's follow this pipe spool manufacturing process sequentially. First, let's bring the pipe fittings we will need. As you see, 3 off pipe pieces, 2 off 90 degree butt weld elbows, 1 off pipe T, and 3 of weld neck flange. After receiving all our pipe fittings, we can start the assembly phase. First, we fit the pipe piece together with a 90 degree elbow and then the pipe T. In the next stage, we install the second pipe piece and second 90 degree elbow to the continuation of the pipe T. During fit up, between pipe fittings and pipe pieces should be cap, approximately 3 millimeters, it is for welding. Then we will install third pipe piece of the continuation second 90 degree elbow. After assembling each pipe fitting, we are checking the smoothness of the pipe spool. On last stages, we will starting to install pipe weld and neck flanges. The smoothness of pipelines is measured by the accuracy of the holes and faces of the flange in the entire pipeline. Accordingly, we keep the installing of the flanges end of the fabrication process. After assembling each flange, we are checking the smoothness of the pipe spool. Finally, we install the last welding neck flange and complete the pipeline fabrication. During fit up, between flange and elbow should be cap, approximately 3 to 4 millimeters gap, it is for welding. Having this 3-4 millimeters gap is for better root welding. Depending on the thickness of the wall of the pipe fittings, this 3-4 millimeters gap decreases after welding, approximately 1 to 1.5 millimeters remains. This tutorial video is finishing here. If you have any question about video, you can write comments in the comments section. You can watch like those videos by entering the links in the description below of this video. If you liked our video, please subscribe to our piping tutorial channel and turn on notifications to be notified of our new piping tutorial videos in time. Your support is very important for us. Let's not miss the comments and likes, my friends. We help improve the skills of pipe fitters with the videos we share. You can help our channel by watching these videos and sending video links to your friends. Thank you for watching. See you on next video. Take care.